Great. endureth. Thine own dear presence to cheer and to guide. Spring for today and bright hope for tomorrow. Blessings all mine with 10,000 beside. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see.
That is so discouraging, and that is so it makes you feel like, wow, they listen. You know, we're painting another song for heaven, and then you never see them again. It's like kicking the cut. And then we need to be able to encourage those people. And one of the ways that the Lord has laid on my heart to encourage them is to show them that way, that truth, and that life in our lives. When we do that, that should help to encourage them in wanting to come and wanting to serve the Lord with gladness. The Bible says to serve Him with gladness. Sometimes that's hard to do because of all the things that are cluttered up in our lives and the things that are going on in our lives. And as some of these other messages that we've been talking about the last couple of weeks was about a battle. You know, there's a battle that's coming against the church, but there is a people in the kingdom of God that can win this battle. And I'm going to start out in Ephesians chapter 6, and I'm going to start out in verse 5. It goes and says this: "Servants, be obedient to them that are your masters according to the flesh, with fear and trembling and singleness of your heart as unto Christ, not with eye service as men pleasers, but as the servants of Christ, doing the will of God from the heart." See, and I'm not here to beat up on anybody, but the Lord is just really laying this in my spirit, that when we come to church, we're not supposed to just be going through a routine. We're not supposed to be doing things out of habit. We're supposed to be doing things from our heart as service to God. We're not supposed to be a robot. You know, a robot will do this and do this. When we are in service to God, we're following the Spirit of God, and we're not supposed to be, well, Bill's sitting over there, so he thinks like this, so I better go do this. No. That is totally not pleasing God. That is not pleasing God. It says to do things from your heart. Who lives on the inside of your heart? The Lord Jesus Christ. And the Bible tells us, as unto Christ. We do things as if we're doing them to Christ. We treat men the way Christ would treat them. We treat women the way Christ would treat them. We do things for God in a way that is godly and that is a good example to those that look at us. Not just because somebody can see us. We're not Pharisees. We're children of the Most High God. Amen? We are the children of the Most High God. And we are ambassadors to Him, and we are supposed to represent Him and do the things that He would have us to do. Amen. With good will, doing service as doing it unto the Lord, and not men. I've worked out on these jobs a lot, and everybody says, "Ricky, why do you do this or why do you do that?" And I tell them right away, "Mike, I'm not working for Shook. I'm not working for Shook. I don't care what Shook does. I'll do what you tell me to do." Well, why do you do it that way? Because I do it like I'm doing it for God. I give it my all. I put my very best into it. And I take great pleasure in doing things the right way, the best that I know how. Amen. See, we're not supposed to be men pleasers. We're supposed to be God pleasers. And one of the things that is so discouraging to me is to see somebody come to the Lord and then they just fall off like they never had that experience. When we come to the Lord, we need to, as Christians, encourage them and tell them, call them, help them, bless them, edify them, lift them up, and let them know that we love them. Because sometimes people come and they don't feel the love. What do they do? See, we're supposed to do all things as if we're doing it unto the Lord. How would you treat the Lord? You'd be up out of here, Lord, oh Jesus, oh here, God. But how do you treat men? We need to treat that situation And those people that are in this situation, as the same way we would treat the Lord Jesus Christ. Knowing that whatsoever good thing any man doeth, listen to this, this is encouraging. And I want to encourage you. Knowing that whatsoever good thing that any man doeth, the same shall he receive from the Lord, whether he be bond or free. See, every good deed you do, the Bible tells us not to grow weary in well-doing. The Bible tells us to do good. Do it. If you've got to crawl on your knees to do good, you keep doing it because God Almighty is watching over you. He sees everything that you do. And in due season and in due time, He will bless you. He will exalt you. He will lift you up. And He will cause people to see because of your humbleness and what you did for Him as doing it like to Him, He will reward that. Amen. And it goes on in verse 9. It says, "And ye masters, do the same thing unto them, forbearing threatening, knowing that your master also is in heaven." How many know that the masters and the bosses and the people that tell you what to do and the way they treat you, this is what he's saying right here. Don't forget, boss. Don't forget, boss. You've got a master too up in heaven. So you better treat your people the same way you should treat them. Because if you don't want to reap what you sow, you better do it the right way. And there's only one way to know how to do that. And that's to know the Word of God and what He says and how He says to do it. You have a master in heaven. Neither is there a respect of persons with Him. He doesn't respect persons. He doesn't put one above the other. What He does, He puts the ones that do His will, and He does for them what He promises He will do. Amen? He puts the ones that do what He says to do, and He blesses them. The number one thing in serving God is obedience. That's the number one thing in serving God, is to be obedient to what He tells us to do. And I say that, and I know I say that a lot, but that's the way it is. He goes on in verse 10, he says, "Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. Put on the whole armor." This is how we fight the fight. This is how we fight the fight that's coming to the Christian. It's not coming to one Christian. It's coming to all Christians. It's coming against the church. Who is the church? We are the church, not this building. This building is beautiful. This building is a sanctuary. This building is a place that we have to come and serve and worship Him and lift Him up. But you and I are the church. We are the ones that have to fight these battles. "For we wrestle not against flesh and blood." And I got ahead of myself. Getting excited here. "Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might." The power of whose might? Your might? No. It's in the power of His might. It's in the power of the One that lives down on the inside of you. That's where your strength comes from. That's where your power comes from. try to discourage you not to do the things that God's telling you to do. And it's trying to discourage you not to do those things because he knows when Almighty God is on a mission, he knows that Almighty God will get the victory. That's why he tries to discourage you, because he don't want you to go, because he don't want you to get the victory. He ain't stupid. He knows the Word of God. He knows how this works. He was with God in heaven. Don't forget that. He knows exactly how God is and how God works. Why does he try to duplicate everything that God does? Because he knows how God is. Amen. Verse 12. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against the principalities, against powers, against the rulers of darkness in this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. What is that? That's all these devils and demons that try to come against us, you and I as Christians in the church. See, there is a realm between here and heaven. That's where Satan's playground. See, but he can't be like God. He's just got a whole bunch of little minions that he sends out to do his little tricks and his little dirty works. But if he can discourage you, he certainly will. He asked God, ask him, what are you doing, Satan? I'm just walking to and fro, seeking whom I may devour. But see, you and I cannot be one to be devoured, because we have the Holy Spirit of God walking on the, we're walking with us, that lives on the inside of us, and we can win any battle that we face. And we can win that battle, and we'll get to that in a second, but I don't want to get ahead of myself again. I get excited when I talk about this, because I know that so many places that God has sent me, I learned there's that one there. There's that one there that God wants me specifically to try to touch. And so many times, I won the victory because Almighty God walked with me. He fought the battle. All I had to do was pray and get on my knees and ask for his help. And I won the battle. How many people do you know that would get out of a concrete pour and go to some guy's house across the street, concrete from head to toe, and pray for somebody to receive Jesus? Would I have ever had the courage to do that on my own? No. Why wasn't that pastor and that preacher in that church that was there every day? Why wasn't he in that church? She said he's in that church every single day, without fail. Why? Because God wanted me to go. Why did God want me to go? Because God was working something in my life and showing me something that was going to be much greater than me. Somebody said to me the other day, he said, how do you do that? And I told him, I said, there's a power that's there to help you. It's hard to explain. I can't explain it. Sometimes just words just fly out of my mouth, and I get a moment, I'm like, I didn't even have time to think of it. It's called the Holy Spirit. See, the Holy Spirit helps us in everything that we do. How many people honestly believe that God is with you in every second of every hour of every day? Raise your hand if you honestly believe that. Then why are we so afraid? Why do we fear talking to people about the Lord Jesus Christ? Why do we fear the evils that we need to confront and stand up against? Do you know that Congress is passing a law, trying to, that fell two votes short of doing away with the Bibles in the White House? Wasn't it two votes? Pretty close to that. What's that tell you? That tells you that there is a wickedness in high places that's influencing them to do exactly what they do. So how do we win these battles? We win the battles by putting on the whole armor of God. The whole armor of God protects you. We talked about this in Bible study. Put on the helmet of salvation. Number one, you know you're saved. So if I go in there and I'm going to talk to this guy and he goes, boom, I'm dead. But I'm not dead, brothers and sisters, because the Lord Jesus Christ lives on the inside of me. He went to the cross. He died for me. He shed his blood for me. And I know that no matter whether I live or whether I die, I belong to the Lord. That is my strength, and that is what I'm going to stand on. If he tells me to go into an army of thugs, I'm going straight in there. Because I know that I cannot lose. I know that I have the victory in the Lord Jesus Christ, the one that died on that cross for my sins and your sins. And he is no respecter of persons. I don't care the lowest of the poor is just as rich as the richest of the richest of the richest in Jesus Christ. Because Jesus Christ paid the price for all. He didn't pay it for some. He didn't pay it and said, now you fight the battle. He paid it and said, you fight the battle, but I'm going with you, brothers and sisters. You don't have to be afraid. You don't have to be scared. You just go do what I told you to do, and I'll show up, and I'll fight the battle, and you'll win the victory. Hallelujah, and you'll glorify me. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Don't you get tired of him picking on you? Don't you get tired of him sitting there doing this all the time? Hey, you can't do that. Yes, I can. No, you might not. You might mess up. No, I won't. And even if I do, I know the one that can fix it. He's always got plan B. He's always got plan C. Because he knew from the beginning if he was going to fix it at plan A or plan B. He's an all-knowing, sovereign God. He's in complete control at all times. The Bible says in verse 13, wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day. Brothers and sisters, I'm here today to tell you that you and I are standing in the evil day. This world is so wicked that it's not even funny. Satan used to hide around the corner, wait to get who he could get. Now he ain't hiding around the corner. He's walking down the middle of the Main Street. He's walking all proud, and his chest run out, and saying, look at what I've done. Look at what I've got. I knew I would get him. But no, 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 he ain't got nobody. He just thinks he's got somebody. Because the one that's coming, the one that's going to say, come up hither when that trumpet sounds and that sky blows wide open and the Lord draws us out of here. We're going to know the glory forever. And he's going to be standing here thinking he's won, but he ain't won nothing. Because 3.5 years later, after that, he's going to be bound up in the lake and the fire of hell. Hallelujah. Give God praise in the time of the Lord. Stand, therefore, having your loins girded about with truth. That's the truth of the Word of God. That's the truth of the Lord Jesus Christ. He said, I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life. And no man can come unto him except through him and can come to the Father. Hallelujah. And having the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod up with the preparation of the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. That means wherever you go, you should be spreading the Word of God. You should be trying to put the Word of God into as many people's hearts as you can. Because that's what we're supposed to be doing. That is the will of God, that we go into all nations and preach His gospel. Because without Him, we got nothing. Without Him, they got nothing. It all comes to dismay. Without the Lord Jesus Christ, none of us have anything. And we want everyone to go to heaven. Amen. I've got people in my family that are not saved, that I pray for daily. Do you have people in your family that you pray for? Then stand up. Stand up against the devil and declare the victory over them through the power of the Spirit of God. Because I know that I know that I know when you get on your knees and you pray and you pray and you pray like that woman that went to the judge, she wouldn't leave him alone because he finally got tired and said, okay, you can have it. It's the same with God. God says, okay, you've prayed for 40 years. Now watch what I do. And when God saved him, God saved him. Hallelujah. Never give up. See, you can't quit the middle of a war just because you think you're getting beat. Do you see an athlete, a good athlete, do you see him quitting in the middle of the game? No, you see him lifting up his teammate. You see him edifying his teammate. You see him encouraging his teammate. You see him keeping the faith that we can do this if we stand together. If we stay together and we stay in unity with God, we can do this. We can still win souls for Christ, no matter how hard he comes against us, because through Christ we have the victory. He goes on and he says, above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. What does it take to kill those fiery darts? It takes the faith of Jesus Christ on the inside of you that you are the victory, that you have the victory, and that the victory is always going to be yours through Him, and that we can win others through Him if we don't give up. Amen. Next verse. Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching whereunto with all perseverance supplications for all saints. And for me, that the utterance may be given unto me, that I may open my mouth boldly. How? Like a little sissy? Is that what he said? That I may open my mouth boldly. That means with power and authority in the name of Jesus Christ for the Christian. With all perseverance and supplications for all the saints, and for me that utterance may be given unto me that make the mystery, that make my mouth open boldly to make known the mystery. Make known the mystery of the gospel. Boldly. For which I am an ambassador in bonds, that therein I may speak boldly as I ought to speak. You see, we have this I know it's probably human nature to want to talk back. But the Bible tells us to do the opposite of that. The Bible tells us to walk and speak boldly about the Lord Jesus Christ. When Paul got thrown in prison, did Paul cower down? When Paul got thrown in jail, or when Paul was shipwrecked, did he cower down? Anything and everything that happened to that man, he used it and found some way to use it to further the gospel. What are you and I doing to further the gospel? Not yawning, Andy. I know I'm not that boring. What are you and I doing to further the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ? Do we talk to people when we meet them? Or do we say, man, not today. Oh, I'll wait till next week. Well, now's not the right time. The Lord says, the Bible says, Today is the day of salvation. Not tomorrow, not next week, right now. Because you don't know if Jenny's going to be here next week, or Dorothy, or Sharon, or Karen, or anybody. You don't know when your time is up. And we want to do and need to do everything in our power. Wait a minute. None of you caught that, did you? You got it, Dorothy. We need to do everything in the power of God, in the Spirit of God. Because God is with us, and who's the victor? God will go with us, and we are the victor. He accomplished all this at the cross that he died. Go ahead, Mike. Well, don't go ahead, Mike. Come on down, Mike. You're the next contestant. See, we need to do everything we can to prepare for the battle that is before us. In the book of Hebrews, it talks about there's a time coming that even the worse and worse the times get, the more we should be gathering. That we should be lifting each other up and edifying each other and encouraging each other to go out and to win the lost. What's our job in this world? Win the lost. I heard Brother Ralph say, how did this thing get away from me for 43 years that I never knew anything about it? It's because no one was bold enough to tell him about it, and one of them was a pastor that had been in his life and he knew. Isn't that sad? That is sad. And I won't mention any names, but if you think I'm kidding you, you can ask him and he'll tell you the same thing. Be bold as a lion. Don't be afraid to roar. Don't be afraid to cause a shakeup. Don't be afraid to stir the pot, as they say. Yeah, you may get some kickback, but who cares? You're a winner either way. If they don't want nothing to do with you, dust your feet off and go on to the next one. That's what Paul said to do. If they don't want to hear you, go on to the next one. If that one don't want to hear you, go on to the next one. At least you're doing what God told you to do. You're being obedient to God. And that's the most important thing we can do, is being obedient to God. Let's go. Turn over to 1 John chapter 5. I want to read some of this stuff real quick. There ain't no way I'd let you out here 17 minutes early. That just can't happen. Everybody there? Amen. 1 John chapter 5, right before Revelation. Right back in the word. 1 John chapter 5, it says this. Whosoever believeth in God, and everyone that loveth him that begat, loveth him also that is begotten in him. By this we know that we love the children of God, when we love God and we keep his commandments. See, God didn't say, this is the deal, or let's make a deal. God said, this is the deal. We don't make a deal with God. We do things God's way because God has already got it laid out what we're supposed to do. We're supposed to keep his commandments. We're supposed to be obedient to him. And when you do that, God is going to help you win the victory. He's proven that to me so many times in my life. He's a good God. He loves every single one of us, from the poorest to the richest. If you're in him and you're doing what you're supposed to be doing, you can bet you're going to win. It may look bad. You may be in the valley. But the only reason you're in the valley is that's for God to build your character and to build your faith and to help you to become and have perseverance to be able to withstand all the things that you're going to have to go through in life. You know, I try to teach you stuff to make. And, you know, you go through dips and high places. It's easy to serve God and shout God to the rooftop when you're on top of the mountain. But how easy is it when you got 4 inches of rain and it flooded out your garden that you love the garden and you're sitting there watching the water run across it, wiping everything out? And I said right then with my little grandson standing beside me, I said, Peyton, it looks bad. It may be bad, but I can tell you this. I will forever give God the glory for the rain. I will give God the power. I will give God my prayers and thanks for what I did have, and it'll all be okay in the end. And within 2 days, the water was gone, the ground was almost dry, and on the third day, I plowed and kept right on trucking. And I said, I will forever praise the Lord. The Lord giveth, the Lord taketh away, but I will forever praise the Lord. And that's what I've done. That's what I've been in my heart. And 3 days later, I was plowing my garden, and it looks just as good as it did before it flooded, and maybe a little better. It's all in your attitude. It's all in doing what God said to do. And I said, no matter what comes against me, I know that God is with me. And He knows how much I love that garden. Maybe He was testing me.
God will test you, though.
Maybe He was testing me. Let's see how He acts to this. He tested Job. He let Satan go right after Job. And He does the same to us. He'll let Satan come at you. But He wants to see how you're going to respond to it. Are you going to fight Him? Are you going to glorify God? Are you going to keep on trucking? Are you going to lay down and cry and give up and just be like a little baby? No, I praised God. I kept praising God. I knew that God would make it right. God is the God that makes it right. Do you get that, church? God is the God that makes it right. It may look bad for a moment, but in the end, you will come out the victor, I guarantee it, every time.
Amen.
He is a God that loves His children. See, right here, He tells us, whosoever believeth in Jesus Christ is born of God. You are born of God, brothers and sisters, because you love the Lord Jesus Christ. And everyone that loveth Him, that begot, loveth Him also that is begotten of Him. See, it's because of Him. It's because of the Lord Jesus Christ. God loves us because we are in Christ. He loves you, and you will have the victory. No matter what. Just because it looks bleak for a little while, don't give up, don't lay down, never back down, never give up. And speak boldly against the enemy. Because he's going to be there. He showed that when he walked into that church, cussing God, going through and trying to hurt people, and doing all those other things. We know who was powering him. The evil and the drugs was powering him to do what he done. But they did what they were supposed to do. They tried to help him. They tried to show him love. They tried to talk to him, and he wanted nothing to do with it. Drugs didn't come from God. The good drugs did, the drugs that helped save our lives. I'm talking about the illicit drugs. The fentanyl. Cocaine, the crack, and all the drugs that just destroy your body, destroy your life. And I pray that that young man gets help. But this is the kind of things that are going to come against us from time to time. And we've got to know how to fight. And we've got to know how to win. And we fight with the Word of God. With the Spirit of God. The sword of the Spirit. The sword of the Spirit means what? The sword of the Spirit means what?
Word of God.
This right here is the sword. God can stand any against any dark ever fire. Now, Nehemiah, that God loves us. He loves us so much. He don't want do you want a bunch of kids that everything they do, they get beaten? How many of you have kids involved every time they get beaten and just walk around like this all the time? Because they can't never win a ball game. Is that the kind of kids you want? See, God wants us to be bold. God wants us to know who we serve. God wants us to know that He is with us. God wants us to know that He's going to give us the victory. And we need to act like that. We need to be bold in who we are in Him. We are nothing alone, but in Him we have it all. And you need to stay armored up because the battle has only just... Who said that? Battle is only just begun. Some general or something back in the day. Yeah. The battle is only just begun. Because He's going to attack. The more and more that you see and you watch what's going on in this world, the more and more bold Satan is getting about this. He don't hide anymore. He just walks down the street just as proud as he can be. You see it in the lives of everyone that he gets close to. You see it in the lives of humanity. So if he's going to do that, then we need to be doing that for a much greater cause. To pull them that he's in control of away from him and pull them in to the kingdom of God. Because we know what their victory is going to be. It's going to be a big loss. It's called hell. No, hell is a real place burning with fire and brimstone. You're either in with God or you're out with God. There is no in between. There is no walking the fine line. Well, I'll sin a little today and I'll be great tomorrow. Sin a little today and then I'll be great tomorrow. No, it don't work like that. You either got to be in or you're out. One of the two. And I want to encourage you today, if you don't know the Lord Jesus Christ, I pray that you'll call on to His name. I pray for all those out there in YouTube world that listen to this. If you're not right with God, if you're still letting the devil shoot those darts at you and hit you, I pray that you'll stop that. I pray that you'll armor yourself up and ask for God's forgiveness and ask Jesus Christ to come into your heart to be your Lord and Savior, that you will have the victory. Amen. Amen. Let us pray. Everybody knows who Jesus is.
bright morning star.